Praise the Lord. May the everlasting peace of God be upon you and your family in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you for connecting. Preach the gospel to the poor. Why? Why the poor? One of the missions of our Lord Jesus Christ, one of these ministries, one of the reasons why he came on this earth, yes, so that you would be saved, but one of the reasons he came to preach the gospel to the poor. One of the reasons our Master Jesus Christ came on this planet earth is to preach the gospel to the poor. Why the poor?
People of God,
if you look around the world, many things which are happening, many wrong things which are happening, they most affect the poor people. Many things, yes, look around the world, they affect the poor people. Hallelujah. Why? Because poor people are so easy target. Poor people are so easily attacked. That is why our Lord Jesus Christ, he said, I am anointed to preach the gospel to the poor. Praise the Lord. These are the prophecies which were said by our prophet Isaiah in the book of Isaiah 61 verse 1. Isaiah 61 verse 1, our Lord Jesus Christ quoted that verse in Luke 4 verse 18. Let us read. He said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He has anointed me to tell the good news to the poor. He has sent me to announce the release to the prisoners, the recovery of sight to the blind, to set oppressed people free. 19. And to announce the year of the Lord's favor. Hallelujah! This was Jesus Christ going back to when he went back to his town where he was raised, where they rejected him. That was the first scripture he gave them. He said, listen guys, one of the assignments I have on this earth is to preach the gospel to the poor. Why? Because he knew that when you are poor, you are limited. When you are poor, you are an easy target. Jesus Christ knew that. Hallelujah. I'm here to tell you, child of God, I'm here to tell you, as a Christian, wherever you are, reject poverty. Poverty is not your portion. He said, I came so that they might have life. I came to give you life in abundance. The devil came to kill, steal, and destroy. But I came so that you will have life in abundance. Hallelujah. Maybe you have been living in poverty. Maybe you have been thinking that Christianity is just going around and preaching the good news to everyone. And then when you are preaching the good news, you just save them. You just save them to accept the Lord Jesus Christ. Fair enough, that's another step. But after someone gives his life to Jesus Christ, the next thing, you have to live that life of richness. Come on. There is no point of saying, I am born again, but yet you are poor. No. Poverty is not your portion. Unfortunately, many people, they haven't realized. They haven't realized that one of the assignments which our Lord Jesus Christ came to do here is to preach the good news, is to preach the gospel to the poor. Why? To the prisoners. Why? To the one who are blind. Why? So that those people, the moment they receive the gospel, because the gospel is the light. When they receive the gospel, when they receive him, the Messiah, when they are born again, after that, they have to take a step for them to be rich. Maybe you have been born again for a long time. Maybe you have been in the ministry. You have been living as a Christian. But you don't have anything to show in life. There is nothing to show. Hallelujah. Listen to this. The Bible says, let us read Second Corinthians. We read 2 Corinthians 8. It says our Lord Jesus Christ, although he was rich, but he was made poor for you and I before you were born again. He said, although he was rich, But he was made poor so that he will taste the poverty, so that he will live that poor life. Ah, he was not made poor just to remain poor, no. He was made poor to come to a level, to make you realize that yes, even our Master Jesus Christ tested what you are testing. Hallelujah. But listen to this. You are not supposed to remain there. You are not supposed to allow, even to allow that life. You have to reject the life of lack. You have to reject the life of poverty. Because your Master, your Father, your Heavenly Father is a rich man. Your Heavenly Father owns everything. He's the Father of gold and silver. He's the Father of heaven and earth. He owns everything. Reject the spirit of poverty. Let us open 2 Corinthians 8. Someone is going to be rich today. It only takes an idea. It only takes a mindset. 2 Corinthians 8. I'm reading from verse 9. For you know the grace of our Lord Jesus, the Messiah. Although, hey, he was rich, for your sake, he became poor. Hey, that you and I, come on now, through his poverty, might become rich. Our Lord Jesus Christ, he was made poor so that you and I, you become rich. You're not supposed to be poor anymore because he has come, he died. Hey, he has experienced, he has lived that poverty. You are not there. Remember, we are the new creation. Come on. We are the new ministers of the new covenant. Let us continue. Verse 10. I am giving you my opinion, says Paul, on this matter because it will be helpful to you. Same as I am giving you my opinion now. Last year, you were not only willing to do something, but you have already started to do it. Come on, you have to do something as a child of God. There have to be a project you are chasing. There have to be something you are working on day and night. Don't just live an ordinary life. No, start something. Have an idea, execute it, go for it. You're not alone. The Spirit of God is with you. The Spirit of God is upon you. Yes, you can do it. Come on now. Verse 11. Now finish what you began, so that your eagerness to do so may be matched by your eagerness to complete it. Which means if you start a project, listen to me, learn to start and finish. Whatever you have started, if you have an idea of a business, if you have an idea of writing a book, if you have an idea of singing, if you have an idea of doing something, start and finish it. Now, let me tell you something. As a born again Christian, whatever you call yourself as a Christian, you pray in the name of Jesus. When people look at you, listen to this. When people look at you, they look at you as a representative of Christ. They want to see everything which Christ said about himself manifesting in your life. They want to see that. Listen to this. We're going to prove it now in the Bible. Let us open 2 Corinthians, I think 2 Corinthians 3:3. 2 Corinthians 3:3. That's it. It's 2 Corinthians 3 from verse 2. You are our letter written in our hearts and known and read by everyone. Which means every step, every action you do, your lifestyle is being read by somebody. People, they just look at you and read. So my question is, what are they seeing in you? Are they seeing poverty? Are they seeing dedicated man? Are they seeing a dedicated woman? Are they seeing somebody with ideas? Are they seeing someone who is pursuing, who is pushing something? Are they seeing someone who is always in creation, in innovation? You are trying something. Are they seeing you doing that? Or are they seeing a gossiper? How people see you represent who you are. How people see you represent your Father. Listen to this. Let's continue. Verse 3. You are demonstrating that you are the Messiah's letter. Hey! Produced by our service. Written not with ink, but with the Spirit of the living God. Come on now. You are the Spirit. You are written by the Spirit of the living God. You are not an ordinary being, man. Come on. Stop despising yourself. Stop taking yourself like a, like nobody. You are, you oh la re ke te li bazooka te brakanda le ka zo 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 baka te ya ke. Hi! It says written not with ink but with the spirit of the living God. Not on tablets. No, not by pen. Not of stone but on tablets of human hearts. For such is the confidence that we have in God through the Messiah. Ah, let's continue 5. By ourselves, we are not qualified to claim that anything comes from us. Rather, our credentials come from God. 6. Who has also qualified us to be ministers of a new covenant, which is not written but spiritual? Because the written text brings death, but the spirit gives life. I'm here to tell you, I'm here to minister to somebody. Reject the spirit of poverty. Reject the spirit of lack. Your father, the Messiah, he was rich. Although he was rich, he was made poor so that you will be rich. Start having the business ideas. Start having the creative ideas. Think of something big. Think of something big. It doesn't matter what it is. It doesn't matter how it looks like. It doesn't matter your situation. Listen to this. You are no longer by yourself, but Christ in you, the hope of glory, the one who experienced poverty, the one who experienced what you are going through, he lives and dwells in you. Listen to this. The more you think of the ideas, what you want to be, the one you want to achieve in life, the greatness, remember, as you are living in this world, there will be time when your time finishes. But my question is, what are your relatives, your kids, or people around you going to inherit? Are they going to inherit air? Or are they going to inherit material? Listen to this. To be rich, it doesn't mean only possession. It doesn't mean owning everything around the world. It's part of it. But to be rich is to have that mindset, is to have those ideas, is to accept that you are a creator, is to accept that the Spirit of God dwells in you. Therefore, you can do anything. You can look at any problem and come with a solution. Hallelujah. Come on. That is the richness I'm talking about. Because you can have money and be poor. You can have money and be poor. Come on now. The gospel is to come to you to give you the fullness. He said, I came so that you will have abundance. He talks about the health, the spiritual, everything complete. God does not only want to give you material but suffer spiritual. He does not even want to give you spiritual but suffer material. No, he wants to give you complete package. You have to pray for the complete package. Don't be one-sided. One-sided is the devil. The devil either is too spiritual or is too physical. There is no balance. But in God, there is a balance. You are spiritual, you are rich, you are everything all in one. This is your life. This is who you are. Come on, go ahead and pray and ask God to help you to be who He looks at you as. Hallelujah. Do not worry about what people have said about you. Just think of what God has said about you. You can make it. What a mind can conceive, what a mind can imagine, it can surely achieve. You are not alone. The Spirit of God is upon you. Yes, you are rich. You are loaded. You are amazing. You are wonderful. You are the helper. You are indeed the light of the world. Have that mindset. Have that mindset of abundance. Have the mindset of I can do it. Yes, you can do it. May the Spirit of God be upon you now and forever. Ha! May you testify even before this year. May something give birth unto you. May you be seen in this world. May your light, may your star shine so that it will attract, it will be seen all around the world. You are a child of God. You are on top. You are not beneath. God bless you. Till we meet next time. Bye now. Shalom.